Namaste, football fans. Welcome back to Football Therapy with me, your host, Yann. I hope you're not doing well, and welcome to today's video, which is on Chelsea midfield superstar Ruben Loftus-Cheek. And he's a really important player, but the big question is, how the hell is Frank Lampard going to fit him into this Chelsea side and into this team? Because he is incredibly important, but obviously we've got people like Mason Mount, who's the golden boy at the moment. We've got N'Golo Kante, Jorginho, Kovacic, Barkley. It's a tough puzzle to solve, but I want to talk to you about why Ruben Loftus-Cheek is so important and then potential ways he can be put into Frank Lampard's Chelsea side. And he really is a very important player, so hold tight. Before we get into the content, quick reminder for you guys to subscribe to Football Therapy because there's daily content uploaded. I want everyone to keep up with said content, so make sure you do subscribe, hit the bell notifications icon, and if you want to help your boy out, you are welcome to by liking the video. Right, Ruben Loftus-Cheek. An interesting story at Chelsea Football Club. Before, like, you know, hudson-odoi, Tammy Abraham, Mason Mount, it was Ruben. Ruben was the golden boy of the academy. He was the jewel in the crown, the player that was supposed to make it, that generally has now, maybe a bit late, but due to probably not having a Frank Lampard when he was in his late teens, or even early 20s, he had to wait a long time, go on loan, but he finally burst through on the scene. He even convinced Sarri last season, which is a hard thing to do, and became a first-choice midfielder last season and was incredibly effective now. I want to stress to you guys that Ruben Loftus-Cheek is that game-changing player like hudson-odoi. A bit different, but he's a bit like that. Some players like hudson-odoi and Ruben Loftus-Cheek, these kind of players are going to be the replacement for your Eden Hazard. Now, I'll tell you why. Because when they pick up the ball and do something, it's different to what the team offers. Hudson-Odoi, when he cuts in from the wing and he does his technical forward play, something different. But Ruben Loftus-Cheek is unlike any other midfielder Chelsea have. When he picks up the ball and drives from deep, he has twinkle toes. He can basically do wonderfully technical thing with his feet, but he can also roll people off him. He can do deft little touches and run on. Or he can just hold possession and drive up midfield and batter people, and people literally bounce off him. I said it before last season, Ruben Loftus-Cheek can be the player to pick up the mantle from Eden Hazard, of the kind of player to get people out of their seats at Stamford Bridge. He did that goal where him and Hazard both scored, and they both scored that identical goal where they curled it into the top corner after a piece of brilliant individual play. But Ruben Loftus-Cheek did it better than Eden Hazard. Obviously, I don't want to compare him too much to Eden Hazard because they're very different. One's got a very low centre of gravity and a big booty in Eden Hazard. And Ruben's more of a bit of a tank, but he really is technically gifted and a great finisher and offers a completely different dynamic to the team in terms of if the plan's not working, you can give it to Ruben and he will drive and score. Or, you know, he's very good at combining technically. He's basically got it all. To emphasise Ruben's importance, last season in only limited game time, he got 10 goals and 5 assists across all competitions. He actually got 6 goals in the Premier League in just 6 starts. His offensive stats and metrics are really impressive indeed. You know, when it comes to dribbling, he's an amazing dribbler. He will be up there with Eden Hazard and Kovacic in terms of how many dribbles he can complete. He had loads of shots per game. Creative too, key passes, but like I said, he's still got that physicality to dominate midfield. Basically, he's just an invaluable player. I think I've hammered that home to you guys now. He's really, really important. He needs to be put into Chelsea's team going forward. But how does Frank Lampard do that? He seems to have a very balanced midfield, I guess. You know, you could definitely do with Ruben Loftus-Cheek. Like I said, he's a different option. For me, he's too good to leave out, but who do you leave out to get him in, and what shape do you use? That's what this video today is about. Fortunately, like Mason Mount, Ruben Loftus-Cheek has played a bunch of different positions, but for me, he plays one position best. Now, you could argue it's the same for Mason Mount. Mason Mount might play the number 10 best or just in midfield 3. I think Mason Mount's probably best playing in the hole as a number 10. But let's look at some formations and let's talk about Ruben Loftus-Cheek. Right, first formation I want to talk about is the 4-3-3. What Sarri did, what Maurizio Sarri employed, he put Ruben Loftus-Cheek in the left centre mid spot when Kovacic wasn't playing. And this made Chelsea much more threatening from midfield. He was a goal threat, he was good at making key passes and also dominating physically. This is where Ruben Loftus-Cheek has done his best work. And throughout his career, he has been moved around to loads of different places, even on the right wing under Roy Hodgson at Crystal Palace. And obviously, Antonio Conte, wanted to play him as a second striker, if not a striker. Madness. But the left centre mid spot in a 4-3-3 suited Ruben Loftus-Cheek perfectly, and he can combine with the technically gifted players down the left-hand side, such as Emerson or Callum Hudson-Odoi, etc. So very, very effective there, and for me, that's his best position. But if Frank Lampard plays this 4-3-3, where does that leave his other midfielders? Obviously, it looks like Hudson-Odoi is going to be making that left wing spot his, Willian on the right, Tammy up front, and he'll have to maybe drop Mason Mount here because he's going to be playing Jorginho at the lone pivot, and he's going to be playing N'Golo Kante on the right. To be honest, it's very, very difficult indeed to see Frank Lampard dropping Mason Mount at this point. He's one of Chelsea's best players, but also the absolute belief in Mason Mount and desire for him to become great is evident in Frank Lampard. So really, it's difficult to see Ruben Loftus-Cheek getting into that formation, even though that's where he does his best work, which is kind of frustrating, but again, probably the old conventional good problem to have. But you know, God forbid Mason Mount just doesn't play the odd game and Ruben gets to play there. Next up, the 4-2-3-1. Now there's two spaces where Ruben Loftus-Cheek could play here. If Mason Mount is playing in the number 10 behind the striker where he does his best work, then Ruben Loftus-Cheek can play in one of the deep midfield two spaces. Again, there's a theory that Ruben Loftus-Cheek could play as a number 10. Obviously, him playing as a second striker was a bit fanciful from Antonio Conte, but for him to play as a number 10 is a little bit more realistic, but I still personally think that's too high up the pitch for him in terms of where he does his best work driving from deep. So I guess Mason Mount playing in the number 10 there, and Ruben Loftus-Cheek playing in the deep midfield too, maybe on the left-hand side next to N'Golo Kante, and perhaps Jorginho is dropped in this situation. Again, for me, it's a little bit wasting him. Both these positions in this formation doesn't get the best out of Ruben Loftus-Cheek, purely because he needs to be occupying that left centre mid spot in a lot of space and with the right kind of license to combine with the left hand side players. Here he will be required to do a lot of defensive work, and probably that will be damaging for Chelsea defensively and damaging for Ruben Loftus-Cheek offensively. So it's causing a problem for me here, and although he could probably play those two positions, it's not getting the best out of him. You might as well play Mason Mount in the number 10 and just play Jorginho and Kante. And the final formation I want to talk about is Frank Lampard's midfield diamond, which he played a lot in pre-season and he's played a few times so far in this domestic season or competitive season. This accommodates both Mason Mount and technically Ruben Loftus-Cheek in his best role. He can play left centre mid. It's not the same as a flat midfield three left centre mid, but he's still occupying roughly the same space with a pivot behind him, say in Jorginho and Kante to the right. But this also accommodates Mason Mount in his number 10 role. So really, this is the midfield to dominate all midfields. Jorginho at the pivot, N'Golo Kante on the right, Mason Mount in the 10 playing in the hole, and Ruben Loftus-Cheek playing that left centre mid role. That is a devastatingly effective midfield, and when perhaps deployed in the Premier League, if functioning with good chemistry, for my money is the best midfield the Premier League can offer. Obviously, this causes problems in terms of the people up top. Has Frank Lampard actually found a front two that can work? Obviously, you think Tammy Abraham is going to play, and then with that, who do you put with him? I guess you put Callum Hudson-Odoi. That would be a really interesting front two to combine. It would probably be a number 10 free role for Hudson-Odoi, and Tammy would try and stay up by himself, but this becomes a very, very narrow system. Still, that sounds very deadly indeed, but people like Christian Pulisic, Willian will all suffer. And does Frank Lampard actually try and play with two strikers like Batshuayi and Tammy again, like he did in pre-season? But then all wingers miss out, so it's very, very difficult. But in terms of accommodating the midfield, that diamond would be excellent to get the best out of both Ruben Loftus-Cheek and Mason Mount, who are two incredibly important players for Chelsea, and you know, Tammy Abraham could still play, so he could still score those goals. So I've talked about the best space for Ruben Loftus-Cheek to occupy, and it is that left centre mid spot. And also, the biggest problem in this whole scenario is Mason Mount, getting them both into the same team. And Mason Mount's best spot is in the number 10, so it makes sense to play that diamond, really. But then you have to lose out on perhaps a winger, and but it'll be difficult to keep all players happy, I guess. This is the conundrum for Frank Lampard, but for me, it's pretty evident so far looking at the players closely in Mason Mount and Ruben Loftus-Cheek where they play best. So if they're happy to sort of rotate in and out different formations, then it should keep the harmony in the squad. But the important thing to note is Ruben Loftus-Cheek cannot be overlooked moving forward when he returns to the side. He is such a valuable and effective footballer, and because he's been out with injury for quite a while, people might actually forget how effective he was and what a difference maker he was when he was playing in this Chelsea side, occupying that left centre mid spot. For me, it's imperative Chelsea getting back, especially in the Premier League, that physicality, that dominance, and you know what, Champions League as well. He's at such an important part of his career. He's so technically gifted, he can score goals, he can absolutely body people off the ball, he can progress your team up the pitch. So important. And in the time of soft midfields in the Premier League, he can be that guy that really batters the opposition down. Really, really important. Ruben Loftus-Cheek has to return to Chelsea Football Club starting 11, in my opinion. Or at least be rotated frequently with Mason Mount. Because if you think about it, Mason Mount's very technically gifted and a goal threat also. But in terms of physicality, he couldn't be more different to Ruben Loftus-Cheek. Anyway, that's my video on Ruben. What do you guys think? I want to hear your opinions in the comment section below. Get down there. How would you accommodate both players? Do you think one's more important, Mason Mount or Ruben Loftus-Cheek? Do you think Chelsea should play a different system entirely to accommodate them both? Let me know, get in the comments below. Remember, if you want to chat to me and other members of the Football Therapy Go Gang about Chelsea and football, join the Discord server. Link in the description below via Patreon, costs $1. Follow me on social media at Football Yannick on both Twitter and Instagram. I'm out, guys. You lot enjoy the football, and I will see you later. Way so tough with that bad boy tuck. I'ma get it how I'm living, I'ma walk the walk. Outline my lines, I rap through thought. Body bag the verse, outline the chalk. In my life seen trouble, hustle on the double. Silence on the trigger like my pick got a muzzle. Yo chick like to guzzle, bad boy stay in trouble. I only love this paper, sorry I don't. I love me baby.